Having to manually switch in components and simulating for impedance matching can be quite a process. While tuning can help you with your impedance matching, the fastest way to get the results you want from your matching network is with the Smith chart utility. Here I have a network that I want to perform impedance matching on. The source has an impedance of 25 plus 30J, and the load has an impedance of 50 minus 40J. While we can use the Smith chart utility without the smart component, we'll soon see why it's easiest to use the smart component. In the Smith chart matching palette, place the component in the place of the matching network. Let's now use the utility. Select the smart component and go to Tools, Smith chart. There's a lot of information on this first window. Let's take a quick look at a few of the most important panes. On the left, we see our palette. This is where you can select lumped components or stubs to add to your matching network. We have the options up at the top to set the frequency on which we want to do the matching, as well as whether or not we want to normalize our Smith chart. In the top right, we can see which smart component on the schematic we're editing. Finally, we see the network response that we can plot, as well as the schematic which will include the elements that we add from the palette. Before we start matching, we have to set a frequency. We'll go with 2 GHz. We now need to set the impedances of the source and load. Select the source pin and input the impedance from the schematic. Now, let's select the load pin and input that value from the schematic. To make sure we don't change these values while matching, select lock source impedance and lock load impedance. First, let's place a shunt capacitor. Select it from your palette and move your mouse until you get onto the same resistance circle as the source. Now let's place an inductor. Again, move your mouse until you have matched the impedances. You can edit your capacitor and inductor values by dragging the move handles. Notice in the top left corner that we can see the values of the inductor and capacitor as we move them. Once you're satisfied with your matching network, select Build ADS Circuit. This will automatically update the smart component you placed earlier to reflect the design that you built in the utility. At any point, you can go back and edit the design from the utility and rebuild the circuit. Note that it is significantly more convenient to use the smart component than to have to record values from the utility and place lumped components yourself. If you're building a simple LC two-element matching network, the Smith chart utility can automatically do this for you. In the utility, select Auto two-element match. We'll select the LC network that we built earlier. When we build the circuit, we get the same response as before. On the main window, we can see the auto-generated network that we just built. A new schematic has been generated that reflects the auto-generated matching network. Thank you for watching this Keysight eSoft EDA tutorial. You can find a link to a free trial of ADS in the video description below.